every officer in the Goodman Police Department, along with its chief, have resigned.
The entire police department in one town, every officer and the chief resigned today.
Breaking news tonight, every patrol officer on the Haskell Police Force quits over a funding fight with their mayor.
It's a major occurrence when a rural town loses its entire police force in a single week.
Tonight, the town of Mingo is without half their police force.
Police Chief Adam Miller then took to Facebook and announced he and his eight officers would resign.
Small towns all across the U.S. are now saving tax dollars while simultaneously becoming safer places to live. Entire police departments across the United States are resigning, often throwing temper tantrums and tossing their badges as they walk out.
I'm done.
Two of his fellow officers also throw in the towel.
And the common thread with all of them seems to be they want more money and more militarized equipment to wage war on you.
Some of the officers' demands included better pay, new life-saving equipment, new vehicles, and opening up new positions to allow for more backup.
Don't be mistaken when they say life-saving equipment. They're not talking about equipment that will save your life. They're talking about equipment that will help them be able to terrorize you while keeping themselves safe, such as MRAPs and other military equipment. The most recent exodus occurring right now in the town of Goodhue, Minnesota.
Tonight, the southeastern Minnesota town of Goodhue is racing against the clock. In less than 10 days, they will be without a police force after the entire department suddenly resigned.
We're not the first, and we won't be the last.
The mayor saying she was saddened to receive the resignations of all seven of its officers, including the chief, in response to concerns over pay.
It was standing room only Monday night at Goodhue City Hall as officials discussed the seven resignation letters they were handed last week.
I think we're all a little bit blindsided by it, but we're resilient and we're going to move forward, but it is hard.
This was Chief Smith on July 26th, sounding the alarm about recruitment problems.
Like I said, this has been 3 weeks now. We got zero applicants and I have zero prospects. I've called every PD around for the youngest guys out there getting into the game. There's nobody getting into the game.
Some 1,200 people live here. The council saying it's considering contracting with the Goodhue County Sheriff's Office for now, as its own officers will work through next week.
I mean, I think we could do okay with three, you know, and feel protected. Our town is pretty quiet.
And that's just it. The police state was never about being protected. It was always about feeling protected.
Their cases will be handed off to the Goodhue County Sheriff's Office.
But this is just the most recent entire police department that's resigned because they don't feel like they're being given enough money and enough toys. This has been happening to dozens of towns all across the U.S. All of these other stories are from just the past year.
Every officer in the Goodman Police Department, along with its chief, have resigned.
The entire police department in one town, every officer and the chief resigned today.
Breaking news tonight, every patrol officer on the Haskell Police Force quits over a funding fight with their mayor.
It's a major occurrence when a rural town loses its entire police force in a single week.
Tonight, the town of Mingo is without half their police force.
Police Chief Adam Miller then took to Facebook and announced he and his eight officers would resign.
Every police patrol officer in Haskell has resigned, packing up their things and turning them into the chief. This after a contentious city council meeting over a dispute of grant funding. Some of the officers' demands included better pay, new life-saving equipment, new vehicles, and opening up new positions to allow for more backup.
I wish the citizens would speak out and let the city council know that, you know, their officers need help.
But the mayor says he didn't know about any of these demands until today. And on top of grant use restrictions, the money just isn't there.
We're kind of stuck between a rock and a hard place because we don't have the money and the people not spending the money, don't have enough revenue.
So you're telling me that's not going to be, there's not going to be done tonight?
No, sir.
Okay, well then my resignation, you have it.
Thank you.
Come out. Y'all can find somebody else to patrol the city.
All right, are all y'all leaving?
Okay.
All right.
I got their names on
there. Use so much more money
than
we have
been
underfunded to begin with. I'm willing
to.
You got more officers and more equipment.
Right. And it costs.
Cell phone video capturing the tension in Monday night city council meeting over police budget axed in half. The other money reportedly reallocated to other city needs.
The total budget for the town is over $4 million.
You take what we were asking for, which was $588,000, now the police department's getting 14% of the total budget.
The police department asked for an increase, a total budget of $588,000 for the next year.
This council is about defunding the police.
No, it's not.
Oh, it is.
No, it's really not.
It's business. It's a math doesn't work.
This is a cut that did not need to be made, at least not 50% anyway.
A few minutes later, the now former chief slides his letter of resignation across the table.
I'm done.
Two of his fellow officers also throw in the towel.
He has not provided services to people in this town.
Fletcher's letter citing a hostile work environment, also saying the massive cuts will cause the remaining officers to be overworked, undertrained, poorly equipped.
Thanks, City Council.
You don't have a police department now. Good luck, guys.
You don't want to defund the police department because you need them. If you don't, you'll have more crime coming into this town.
I want the same thing y'all want. I want protection.
We begin tonight in the small southeastern Colorado town of Springfield in Baca County.
The county sheriff's office is now tasked with covering for the town after every member of the police department, including the chief, resigned this week.
In a matter of days, all three police officers employed in the town of Springfield have left their posts. On Tuesday, Mayor Tyler Gibson says the town was notified of the resignations from the Springfield Police Department, effectively leaving the town's department unable to function. 2 days later, the Baca County Sheriff's Office agreed to take over law enforcement operations in the town of Springfield.
And where entire departments aren't resigning, local officials of small towns are starting to realize that a police department in a small town is absolutely nothing more or less than a tax burden on the people.
What started as a special meeting called to reinstate the Varnell police chief after suspension ended with the dissolution of the entire police department.
But what most people fail to realize is that these small town police departments usually don't solve crime at all. They usually don't have detectives and don't have officers with the knowledge and the ability to actually solve crimes. Most, if not all, of the actual crimes are subbed out for the sheriff's department to handle. And the only thing the local police usually do is roll around, talk to people, give out citations, and bother people who weren't bothering anybody else. So in almost every jurisdiction where this has happened, sheriff's departments and even the state police sometimes come forward to let people know that the truth is this isn't actually going to change anything.
We answer all the major calls in Varnell right now. So again, yeah, we don't anticipate a major workload addition whatsoever.
The sheriff's department will still handle the investigation of all the actual crimes, just as they always did. And in almost every instance, they claim that it won't put any further burden on the sheriff's department.
Councilman Jan Pourquoi, who presented the motion, says it needed to be done. With Varnell's residents paying city and county taxes, he says they don't need a police department.
We need to create the maximum bang for the buck for the taxpayer in Varnell. The way to do that is eliminate duplications we are now having in terms of law enforcement.
People think we need to be over-policed because they actually believe that police keep us safe, even though statistics actually show that police are present for roughly 1 or 2% of crimes.
I don't know how you can change money to help somebody else and take away from the protection of the citizens. That to me should be the number one rule, is to protect the people that live within your city.
Meaning that at least 98% of the time, if a crime is being committed against you, you're on your own and you need to take care of yourself. That means that 98% of the time, the only thing that police can actually do is show up after the fact and take a report. Statistics show that roughly 50% of violent crimes are solved and roughly 25% of property crimes are solved. That means it's almost a guarantee that no cop is going to be present when a crime is committed against you, and that there's less than a 50% chance that that crime will ever be solved. If you don't take responsibility for your own safety and security, you're screwed. And if the first thing that you reach for when somebody is breaking into your house is a phone instead of a gun, then you're probably about to win a Darwin Award. And of course, there's the argument that some people in our society just simply don't have the ability to take care of themselves. But unfortunately, the uncomfortable fact of the matter is that 98% of the time, police can't help them either. I believe it's our responsibility as neighbors and community members to help take care of each other. And we should all do the absolute best we can. But the truth is, there will never, ever, ever be a guarantee of safety anywhere, anytime. And no matter how big we make our government, that will not change.